A number of years ago, my wife and I had a memorable tour through Peru, enjoying its sights, culture, landscape, and history. Join me on the second of a two-part series as we venture into the jungle of Peru to Aguascalientes and visit Machu Picchu high on the mountain. We return over the highlands to Cusco, ancient capital of the Inca Empire, with a stop at the ruins of Sacsayhuaman. In part one of our Peru trip, we flew to the capital city of Lima, and then continued to Cusco, high in the Andes Mountains. We made our way down the Sacred Valley with a few stops, and ended at the Incan town of Ollantay Temple. Our journey now continues with a scenic train ride to Aguascalientes, enjoying the town with a visit to mystical Machu Picchu. We continue our way back over the highlands of the Andes to visit historic Cusco and the ruins of Sacsayhuaman. There are two routes to Machu Picchu from this point. The most popular route is the 4-day hike on the Inca Trail. We take the second route on a 90-minute train ride to the small town of Aguascalientes at the base of Machu Picchu. It's a scenic ride, which actually extends all the way back to Cusco. Rail construction to Machu Picchu was completed in 1928. There's only one track through the valley, so trains need these pull-offs in order to pass each other. This is the Urubamba River, the same one we saw along the Sacred Valley, and it continues on past Machu Picchu to feed into the Great Amazon River. Notice as we proceed, the mountains get larger, the valley gets steeper and narrower. It also gets greener and lusher as we descend into the start of the tropical rainforest. As we watch this transformation, our excitement builds as we're getting close to this most famous destination.
We want to make this visit an unforgettable experience.
Here we are at Aguascalientes, sometimes called Machu Picchu Town. It didn't exist at the time of the Incas, nor when Machu Picchu was rediscovered back in 1911. Back then, only a few families lived here. The town grew to serve tourists visiting Machu Picchu. Machu Picchu sits high on a mountain ridge at an elevation of 2,400 meters, or about 8,000 feet. Inca Emperor Pachacuti built Machu Picchu around 1450. And fortunately, the conquistadors never found it, or it would have been largely destroyed. Without a doubt, no other place is more identified with the Inca world than Machu Picchu. And no other place is as mystical or fascinating, earning it the title of one of the new seven wonders of the world. It is a huge, spectacular complex. You will want to watch my in-depth video on Machu Picchu as we walk through it end to end, showcasing its many sites and sharing some history. You'll have the option to play it at the end of this video. We now ride the train back to Oliente Tambo. Then we hop on our bus for a scenic trip to Cusco through the Andean Highlands. At the town of Urubamba, we drive a switchback road up and out of the Sacred Valley. I'm used to driving up a mountain and going down the other side. However, once we reach the top, we unexpectedly found ourselves on a high plateau with plains that continue for miles. Here we are in the highlands of the Andes, which we ride all the way to Cusco, enjoying scenic vistas, farms, and villages along the way. About one-third of Peru's population lives in the highlands, with about half of the productive land. Cusco sits at an elevation of 3,400 meters, or about 11,000 feet. It's actually about 3,000 feet higher than Machu Picchu. Cusco is considered to be the oldest city in South America. The Inca Empire originated in Cusco, which started as a small city-state in the 11th century called the Kingdom of Cusco. By 1530, it was the capital of the Inca Empire, with a network of roads spanning out in all directions, covering most of the Andes Mountains. In its historical old town, we now visit the Cathedral of Santo Domingo. It was built on an Inca stone foundation of what was the Inca's most holy place. Right here was Inti Cancha, meaning Temple of the Sun. It was also called Coricancha, meaning Golden Courtyard. Dedicated to the sun god Inti, the temple had some 4,000 of the highest ranking priests. Spanish reports say that ceremonies were conducted around the clock and the temple was fabulous beyond belief. Just imagine the spacious courtyard filled with life-size sculptures of animals and a field of corn, all fashioned from pure gold. The floors were covered in solid gold, and all the skillfully carved granite walls covered with more than 700 sheets of pure gold, weighing around 2 kilograms each. Facing the rising sun was a massive golden sun disk encrusted with emeralds and other precious stones which reflected the sun and bathed the temple in a golden light. Well, upon seeing this, the conquistadors thought they'd found El Dorado, the lost city of gold. So after it was emptied of gold, the conquistadors demolished the temple, and in its place they built this Cathedral of Santo Domingo, retaining the Inca stone foundations. Construction of the cathedral started in 1554 and took about 100 years to complete. Most of the stones were taken from the fortress of Sacsayhuaman, which we will visit shortly. Major earthquakes have severely damaged the church, but not the Inca stone walls. Today, we can only imagine what this temple would have looked like, but we can still admire the fine Inca stonework, its mortarless masonry and earthquake-proof trapezoidal doorways. And on the outside, you could see more of the Inca foundation with curved retaining walls. Across the way is a Jesuit church, also built on a famous Inca site. This used to be the palace of the Inca ruler Haina Capac, which was said to be the most beautiful palace of all Inca rulers. Towering high above Cusco are the ruins of Sacsayhuaman, probably the most important Inca monument after Machu Picchu. It was thought to be a military fortress of the Incas, however, current thinking is that it was a temple devoted to the worship of the sun. It was constructed back in the 1440s, and its big walls have massive blocks, each a unique shape with the perfect fit in traditional Inca style without mortar. These limestone blocks came from a location 6 miles away. The biggest blocks are on the bottom, with the largest being 361 tons. Spanish writings say that each of the three walls was 6 times higher than a person. Unfortunately, only 1/5 of the original complex remains, but the site is impressive. And the name Sacsayhuaman means satisfied hawk. Every year on the 24th of June, Cusco celebrates the Festival of Inti Raymi, Festival of the Sun. The conquistadors abolished it, and it didn't resume again until 1944. The celebration starts in Cusco and concludes here at Sacsayhuaman. Today, it is the biggest festival in all of Latin America after the Carnival of Rio. You may remember the story I told you in part one about ruler Manco Inca, who led the Inca resistance at Ollantaytambo, where they temporarily held off the conquistadors. Well, before his stance at Ollantaytambo, Manco came the closest to reclaiming their Inca empire with a siege of Spanish-controlled Cusco in 1536. Manco assembled an Inca army and used Sacsayhuaman here as their base. His siege of Cusco began with an attack on the main square, which we were previously at. He succeeded in capturing most of the city, but the conquistadors managed to take refuge in a couple large buildings, and the Incas couldn't get them out. The Spanish then mounted a counterattack against their base here at Sacsayhuaman, with an assault at night using scaling ladders. They managed to capture the terrace walls, and then stormed the towers and took Sacsayhuaman. So that's when Manco moved his base to Ollantaytambo, where they managed to continue scrimmages in Cusco for 10 months, but the Spanish cavalry was eventually too much to overcome. The conquistadors received reinforcements from Chile and easily retook Cusco. That's when Manco Inca withdrew to the forested region of Vilcabamba, where their last independent Inca state survived another 35 years until they were found. We conclude our last night in Peru back in Cusco with a wonderful dinner and local entertainment. If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified of new releases. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.